Hi all, welcome to my channel, welcome to my world, it's the world away. And this is a new one. I'm having a video out on a Sunday, but the video today was actually recorded on Wednesday with the Patreons, and I have edited it down and added a whole heap of new cameras. Today I'm going to show you how I'm building the Sterling Kit Tetching, I think that's right, Tetching Robot. And this is part one. Hopefully it's going to be two parts, but check this out. Now, Sterling Kit are the company that I was building the V8 engine for, and they wanted to know, would I be interested in maybe building a robot? And I was like, God, yeah, this is going to be excellent. And when you see the video that you're about to see now, the parts are amazing. It's all metal. It works absolutely brilliant. And what I'm going to do is just quickly show you the instructions now of the parts that we get up to in this video, and then I'll come back to you and we'll start the build. So just so you know, this is what the box looks like. It's a metal tin. And you've got the instructions on here, and you'll see some of the parts are already missing in this because this is what I built last time. But all the parts are numbered. Every single thing in here is metal, just so you know. It even comes with the lithium batteries to actually power it. So we've got that section there. Anything to do with body and electrics is in here. And obviously, we have got the instructions here. So put these to one side. This is what the instructions look like. Now they're in Chinese and English, as you can see there. And basically, first off, it's telling you about some of the precautions to make. Then it's telling you how to actually put screws in, how to put bearings in, how to make sure everything's going together absolutely perfectly, where everything is going to connect onto the control board there. Then the app, because obviously this robot is able to be controlled and learn and play music. It's going to be an all singing, all dancing. So we have got an app that's going to link to that. And then once you've got that, it's actually going to go into the build. Now, in today's episode, part one, you're going to see me build all of this, which is the gear and I think the left side of the body for the movement. Then we're going to be doing the other side. And I'm going to keep turning to show you how far we get. That's the other side there. Then once that's done, we're going to create some of the arms here. We're going to create the lights or the eyes. They look like eyes, they do. And then we're going to be mounting the control board. That's all we're going to be doing in this video. But believe me, there's quite a lot in there. And then as we go on, as you can see, we're going to be assembling the main body of the robot, putting the movement gears in. So it's looking like that. And then finally, by the end, look at that. We're going to have an all singing, all dancing robot. Even the chain on the wheel here is metal, which looks absolutely brilliant. And the other good thing I like about this, which was a bit confusing when I did the live stream, was that if there is a problem with your robot, then it tells you how to problem solve that in the instructions, how to take things apart again and how to problem solve it, which I think is brilliant. But that is all the instructions for that. So let me show you the build. Now they number each part. Now all the parts come into a pack just like this. Now, every single thing you see in here is metal, which is crazy. The chains, everything is metal, which is going to be an absolutely brilliant robot. And then we've got the real big pieces over here. And they look just like this. We've got the head sections here. Motors, little servos here. But again, it has the numbers are on here, but it doesn't actually relate to anything until I see the instructions. Looks like we've got the PCBs, control boards in there as well. So, oh, look. I wonder what's on that. Do you reckon the instructions are on that as well? Perhaps they are. I haven't looked at that. We've got a switch. And looks like we've got something we can charge it up with. I think it comes with a rechargeable battery. I don't know if it comes with the batteries. We'll have to figure that one out. So, that is what we're building. So, we're going to be starting to install the right gear assembly. Now, the right gear assembly is number 03. So I'm guessing it's a case of just getting the box and looking for 03, which is that one there. So let's take that out. Right, we need the screws number 60. Now, all the screws and gizmos and stuff come in here, and it tells you in each compartment what's in there. So if I find number 60, which is up here, and I take the sponge out, there we go. We've got a load of screws. Now, the screw that we need, M16 times 4mm screws. So it's the small screws that I've got in here. I'm going to have to use a thing to get these out. So what we're going to do is we're going to be attaching a motor to this, which is motor 35. God. So again, looking at my box of tricks, none of the electrics are in this one, so it's not going to be there. So in this one, number 35 is one of these ones. They're both the same motor. So I've got the motor here. Excellent. Something's going right. Now, when we put this on, they're saying we need to make sure that the lead is coming out the left side, which it will be. And this is going to be going into the center here, just like that there. Now I'm looking at how big those holes are. It's definitely not them screws. So stand by. One. And there should be another one. There we go. Two. So I'm going to screw this in from the top. Lining up the holes. There we go. And then we'll get one of these in. Now, it is nice having these Allen key things, but I am starting to think I should have used one of the, you know, the pens you can get, which have got these on. That's probably the better way to go. But I believe that's the first one in. Let's put the second one in. Now, this robot, I said, it does learn things. It's also a speaker as well. And it lights up and it's all singing, all dancing, from what I understand. And there's the second one. I'll make sure that's nice and tight. So that was stage 1.2 done. So we need some gears, lots of gears. There's a lot of things in this stage now. So part 12, which is there, just one of those. We also need part 18, one of them. Part 54, which isn't in here. I believe that might be in my little box here. It is. It's an M3 snap ring. M3 snap ring. I'm just going to look at this to the picture. So it's one of these. One of them. We're going to need part. So let's do one part. This one thing at a time, I think. That's probably the best way to do this. Otherwise, we're going to get confused. So keeping that this way round, we're going to have this going through that section there. Just like that. We're going to have this on top of that engaged into it. All the way down. And then we're going to be putting a snap ring over the top. Now, I believe these, I haven't used one of these before. I think we just slide them on and that will keep that in place. I've seen them on cars. So as long as you're clipped them on, I think that can go probably a bit further than that. See if I've got something that can help me. Stand by. There you go. And that's clipped on. So that's not going anywhere. Oh, wow. I like that. Can you hear that? That mechanical part? Good. Okay, so let's do the other side. So we need part 45. Part 45. Where's part 45? It's not there. Is it in here? It is in here. Wow. Okay. Part 45 is in here. And that's a transitional gear shaft, which looks like... Stand by. Aha. Which looks like that. And then we need part 54, which is... What's part 54? It's a snap ring, another snap ring. I should have got two out then, shouldn't I? Okay, let me grab another snap ring. 1 second. Part 54, and then part 11. Okay, which I've got here. Stand by. Part 11. Look at the blue on that. I love the colours on this. I would love a car. That's one of my favourite colours, this one, just so you know. I do like blue, but a metallic blue. Wow. Absolutely love it. Okay, so this one, very similar to before. This is going to go into this hole. No. They're saying it's going into this hole here. That one there. Excellent. Put the gear on top this time. And then once again, secure that in with a snap ring, which does need... Ah, Did it with my hands there. So we've got a nice working gear. That's looking good. And then I need part 14. Stand by, looking for that. Aha. The colours are brilliant. I love the colours. Look, that's a gold gear. Doesn't say to put a snap ring on top of it. It's just saying to put that on top here. And it is semi-circular, but it's been cut really weird. There we go. So those gears are now interlocked. No pin. They don't want any pin on that one. So I believe we've done good. So that's 1.2.2. We're now going to be putting in a belt. So we need 75. Where's the belt going to be? That's probably going to be, just looking at all my box of tricks, it's probably going to be in here. This is quite a fun little build, actually. 75, the belt's in this one. Uh-huh, there we go. Very good. And then this is going to be going around this pulley here and the one that I've just put in there. Make sure it's flat. Excellent. And there we go. That's good. We're doing good. We're going to assemble the right gear on top of this now. So I need parts 58, which are one of these screws. One, two. Guessing that's what we need. And we need part 005, which looks like... Help me. 005. There we are. It looks like that one. So that's the part we need. I love how everything's metal. It's absolutely brilliant. Okay, so this is going to be going on this way, over the top like that. And we're going to be securing that in, at the moment, just on these two sides with one of these screws here. So I'll just do that with hand. I do think there was a slight difference in the shape there. Get that tightened up. One in, and there's the two one. Oh, it does tell you it has got a shape. So I had put it in the wrong way. Excellent. So that's those in. But we are going to start now to assemble this to the wall. So I need the wall, which is number 24. This will be the first side of the robot. So number 24 is here. I'm going to make sure it looks like the picture. I don't think it's that one. I think it's this one. Stand by. It's this one. That's 24. Okay, put this back down. And we also need some risers, which are number 55. Let's find that. That's going to be in here. And they're called locating pins. Let's see what they look like. I'm guessing they're these little pins here. We need two of them. 024, we've got that, and we also need some of these 58 screws again, which I don't think we're gonna have a problem finding, because there's hundreds of them. Okay, I think this is gonna be a bit tricky because those pins are quite tiny. I'm just gonna see where the pins go. They go into these little sections just here. So they've got one in here like that. And another one, well, hey, just like that. That's the pins in. Then we get to put this whole thing now, just figuring out over the top. So it goes in kind of like this, with the pins engaging into those sections there and there. Excellent. And then we're just going to be screwing this down with three screws into the top sections here. This is great. I like this. One, two, and three. And I'll get this tightened up. Unlike any build we've done, the quality of this is amazing. That's what that's looking like. Check that out. That's brilliant. So we're good with that one. So we can now go on to the next stage, which says we can do a power check. Aha. This is interesting. Wow, You're going to love this. Right, okay, so we do have a battery. They provided two of these. Very strange looking battery, I have to say. But we do get to check it. It says there's power on and check whether the motor operates. So what do I need to do? How can I do that? There should be a link cable. The link cable's number 81. Stand by. Let's just get the link cable out as well. That's here. You can't fault these instructions, I tell you. Everything we need is exactly where you need it. Right, okay, so we're going to test it. I love this. Right, okay, so I'll plug this end into here. Just like this. And then this, when I plug it in, it's probably going to do something, I guess. I hope. There you go. And it's working, as you can see. That is excellent. So we have got drive now for our lovely little robot. I'm just going to disconnect that. Everything works. This is great. I love having the battery. So we need now part 04, which is this one. We're also going to need two lots of 60. Not quite sure what that is. Let's have a look. 60 is, looking at my box of tricks here. Oh, it's these tiny screws again that we had last time. Two of them, lovely jubbly. And then we need the motor 35, which was in here. And it's pretty similar to what we did before, but this time the motor's going to be going into this end here with the cable going off in. Let me just see what direction they've got it. They want it going up. So it's going to go in. It's going to go in that way, just like that. That looks good. So screw this into place again with those funny hex screws. Can't wait to see what this thing's doing. If I can just have it running around the workshop, that'd be brilliant. But I've never seen those. The only time I've seen those batteries were in mobile phones, to be honest with you, really old mobile phones. I don't know if anyone's had a look on their site yet. I put the link for all of this, just so you know, in the video description. But I've got no idea how much this is, I have to say. Then we're going to be putting these stays in again. So 012, we need one of them. 012, 18, and you guessed it, a clothespin 54. There's plenty of these in here, that's for sure. I think that's going to be the thing of choice in here. If we get two of them out, I'm sure we're going to need two. And then once again, we do exactly what we did before. So in the top this time, with the motor side, that's going to go through there. This is going to go on top, like that. And then we're going to close that off with this pin. Make sure it's round the right way. Ah, got it. Excellent. So we've got one motor section in there, and then we've got the gear 014 to go on, which looks, this was the one that I had problems installing last time. Let's hopefully get it on this one. And there we go, look, that's fitting perfect that time. So that's that. And then we're going to be putting a pulley between those points. This time the pulley is number 74. Is that the other one we got in there? Nope, it's going to be in here. Different pulley this time, bigger one. That looks like that. Got two of these. Then we're just going to be putting this belt between these two here. And I'm guessing they're going to have me testing it. Make sure that's not twisted. That looks good. Excellent. So once we've done that, no, they don't want us testing it. They want us to put the gear cover over. So we need the gear cover, which was looking like that. And we're also going to need two of the 58 screws, which were the ones that we've got hundreds of. I'll get two of them out. One and two. Okay, how's this go on? So this is going to be going on. Make sure it's the right way around with these facing down, it says. And it kind of goes on, whoops. Like that, I guess. There we go. And we want two screws just through the top ones here. One and two. So we've done that, and that means we can now install that into the right hand side of the body. Oh, sorry, the left hand side of the body, they're calling that. So we need the other side of the body, which looks like this. Make sure it's round the right way. I think that is round the right way. And then we're going to be putting this onto this. Now we do need those little pins again, which was 55. God, should have got them out before. Stand by. As I find parts, yeah, these definitely go in here. I think these are his eyes, you know. Look, they're immaculate. They look brilliant. I'll get two of those pins out. One and two. Put them in again so I don't break anything. And then once again, looking at the instructions, these pins are going into one here and one here. And then this is going to go on top into these points there and there. That's two sides of his body complete. Okay, so we've done that. It says this is how it should look. It does, and it's telling me about what happens if it looks abnormal. So once again, we're going to do a test on it with this great little battery pack here. I think this is great. So as soon as I plug this in, it should start. I'm just going to untangle this. Stand by. There we go. Put this in. And we are good. I can hear that straight away. As you can see, gears turning in there, making a lovely noise. Turning on top there as well. So, two successful things at the moment. You know what? I was terrified about this before I started, but it's not that bad. It's not that bad to build. It's actually quite easy to follow along. It does get confusing where the next instruction is to take it all apart again. They're showing you how to disassemble it, which is just crazy. Because, you know, if I didn't know any better, I'd be like, so why are we going to take this apart now? Don't know. Those things that I thought were eyes, they are eyes, but they are spotlights. And it's what we're going to be doing next. So let's have a work on these eyes. This should be fun. So we need 76. So we know they're the eyes. Let's get them out. Just going to move those two to one side. So one and two. I'll put this split ring back because I don't need it to where it goes. We also need 19. Number 19. Where's that? Aha. We need the little irises, I guess. That's what those two are. They're all metal as well. We need 73. I just saw those. They're in here. These are the little sort of O-rings. One and two. Then we need a light base, which is number 36. All the electrics are on this tray right here. So number 36 is in here. Get this open. That's going to be that base right there. I can see it straight away. Oops, let's get it out. It's going to be this. Now, they haven't got theirs plugged in, so I'm going to unplug mine from the main control board for now. Because it's this that I want. And then finally, I need four 72 screws. No idea what they look like. They're in here. Right, I can see them. I can see them. They're very tiny. I'm going to fish these out so you can see what they look like. One, two. Hey, come on. Three. And four. I'm just checking they're all the same. They are all the same. Excellent. So let's assemble these eyes. And we do get to test the eyes as well. It's going to be fun. So the way they go is we have an O-ring. Just checking this out. So we have an O-ring on the base. Like that. Then the lenses fit over the top. Like that. And then these go completely over the top of those. Like that. And it's held in from the underside with those tiny screws. And this time, they are screws. So I get to actually screw that together. So that's one. And number two, just going in the side here. Whoops, there we go. That's excellent. And then we just do the same on the other side. So O-ring, all the way down, lens, and then the iris part, whatever that's called. God, I feel like I'm building the Iron Giant. And screw this in from this side here. That's one. And two. I'm eager to test it, but I don't think it's going to let me. Hang on, I can't get this one in. Just rotate that round a touch. So now, rather than have the 1.4, 1.4.1, 1.4.2, we're actually going to 1.5. And that looks like that. I'm not going to test it because I don't want to blow the lights. But that's what the eyes are looking like. And then we're going to start to assemble the left and right arms. We need loads of bits for this. So let's get this right. We need 49. Looking at all my parts again. They're probably going to be little, aren't they? 47, 40. Yep, so 49. We need a bevel gear, which looks like this. We've got to do this twice, I think. Yeah, we've got to do this twice. I might as well get two out. So one and two. If everything I get out is repeated. So then I need number 15. One and two. I love how everything is metal. This is great. Then I need number 32. Which looks like is this one. One, two. Then I need number 9. There's a lot. Right, I got a number 9. Stand by. That's going to go on that one. But the right-hand one just has number 10. Which is a different sort of attachment which is going on it. That's going to go over here. Then we need, that's it for this one. So I guess I can actually put this one together. I'm just trying to figure out how this goes though. So that's going to go in like that there. This is going to go in like that. And then we're just going to screw the top down, I'm guessing, onto here. Yep. So that's, I'm guessing, the right arm looks like that. The left arm, we've got a couple more bits to put in. We've got 51 times 3. That's probably going to be in here. So we've got some posts. One. Two. And, oops. Three. Then we need number 52, which is this. Whoops. Looks like, tweezers are your friend, definitely, on this one. I say that, and I can't pick it up. I can't pick it up! There we go. And then finally, number 50. Which is a little swivel that goes on the end. That's this thing here. God, there's a lot. There's a lot for this one. And it's just a case of assembling this arm together. So once again, that section there is going to go on the end like that. Then we've got the bracket over the top. Then we've got this thing, which looks like the top of a spaceship. That's going to go on there like that. Then we've got these little posts, which have got a thick end and a thin end. It's the thick end that we're going to be putting into the sides of this. So one in there. One in there. And one in the top there. Then we're going to put this over the top. To hold all of them in place. I bet this is going to be fun to get in. No, we got that in and fine. And then we're going to close all of that off by putting this on the top and screwing that down. A little bit fiddly with those posts in, but it can be done. And that's another arm complete. That was excellent. That's two arms done. Pretty happy with how they look. Okay, so we've got Assemble the main body front cover. So I need body front cover number 72. That's going to be, that's exactly what I'm looking for. So we've got that, and we also need some stays, which are number 47, which are copper cylinders. So I'm looking at them. Aha, these look like motherboard stays, I think they're called. And they look like this. One, two. They normally lift up motherboards from PCs. When I used to build PCs, you used to get these in different sizes all over the place. But they are perfect. Okay, so. Oh, we also need some screws. Number 72 screws. Looking at that. That's... these are small ones, right? Okay, stand by. We need four of these. One, two. Oh, come on. Three. And wahey. Come on. The amount of things I've lost to these tweezers from it pinging off in directions, I'm telling you. Crazy stuff. Okay, so these stays are actually going to be going. Trying to figure out the pictures here. It looks like they're going on top. So they're going into this section here and then secured in from the underside. I'm hoping that's what it is. Yeah, it is. I've just seen the picture next to it. So I'll get these in. Let's put a screw in first so I can line that up and just do it this way. That way I can ensure it's gone on straight. So. One, there you go. Okay, so that's in place. Now we're going to be putting a circuit board in. I'm going to be attaching a control board to this. I wonder if it is that. I think it is that. It is, because look, it fits perfectly in there. Oh my God. Okay. Wow. Okay, so we need number 56 screws for this to go into. That's amazing. And obviously the switch, I'm guessing it needs to be that way around, doesn't it? So the switch comes out the side. And there's the on-off button. And you've got a volume control here as well. You can obviously play around with the volume. That's brilliant. Okay, let's try and get this in without breaking anything. I'm trying to figure out how this goes. Right, we're going to be screwing this in with some 56 screws. Seeing what they are. They're quite tiny, actually. They're hexagonal ones again, by the look of it. Then we need four. One, two, three, and four. Oh, come on. And these are going to be going in from the top side here. So I'll get this loaded up and we'll see what this looks like. I'm hoping I get to test something. Oh, come on. That's the problem with these. They're not magnetic. Just makes my life a little bit harder. Okay, so that's all four of those in. Let's see if we get to test something. Do we? We don't, I'm afraid. We're just going to be starting the rear cover. Ah, so there we go. That's what we've done in the first part of this. All of those pieces there. We've tested two of them when we put the main control board in. So that was just part one. Now, I believe they told me it takes about 2 to 2.5 hours to build. And obviously, the live stream was an hour. And I've managed to edit this down to about 24 minutes, which is a testament to how much chatting I was doing on the Patreon stream. If you want to join Patreon, then I've just put a link down here to the Patreon site. You can join that from as little as a dollar. And we have fun every Wednesday. And there's normally updates as well through the week. And we do have a prize giving draw at the second of every month for something from the merch store. But I really do hope you like that video. If you did, please remember to give me a thumbs up, and if you haven't subscribed already, please remember to subscribe. Other than that, take care.